Hello and welcome to another episode of Squirtified Engineering. I'm Sprutis, and if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and pressing that bell button for notification. So today is another day where I will be working on my daily driver, Peugeot 206, and the starter motor is going out. So I bought a new one, picked it up yesterday. So I will show you how I do that, but we start in the engine bay first. It's quite dirty, but all we need to do here, hopefully, is just disconnect the battery, like so, and then we can raise it up. The old starter is out. There's a slight change in design. Hopefully that won't be a problem. The pitch is the same on them, and I think it's good. One difference is this solenoid has a spade connector, where this one has a threaded post. So instead of cutting the wire, I will create a small adapter. And here we have two of the screws that hold the starter motor in place. Oh, I also saw something else. This one needs to be moved over. But two of them I was able to reach with this one from underneath, and then the long 8mm socket for the solenoid activation post. I used the 13mm socket for the power connection. I had to remove the air filter box from maybe I didn't need to. Maybe I could have just removed this one, but maybe it's too tall to get out. But it's just some screws and a clamp, and then the PCV connection, which is a push-in. So I will make the cable and then reinstall the new one. Here we have the adapter. I just took the cable that was in front of me. Fits there. And here. So I will use this screw and washers, and then I will cover it in electrical tape.
Everything is back together. Off camera, I just reinstalled the air filter. And as you saw, it works.
So, you don't need a lift to do this work. Everything can be done from above. So I could have as easily have done it at home. I've never done it on a French car before, so you never know. But it was quite easy in the end. A bit tricky with some screws, but that's normal. Nothing rusted or something like that. But I will keep the old starter in case this one shows the same problems. Then the problem lies elsewhere. But hopefully this is the fix. I also need to replace the windshield, and it would be a bit embarrassing leaving the car with the glass guys and they can't move it because the starter needs to cool down. But we'll see. So thank you very much for watching. If you haven't done it already, then please subscribe and smash that thumbs up button like all the cool kids say. So take care, stay safe, and bye.